Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Funda family. In this video, I'll be going to explain you Harvard architecture in computer system. So here in Harvard architecture, you'll be observing CPU is interfaced with two separate memories. One memory that will be holding program and second memory that will be holding data. So when program is getting executed inside CPU, you'll be observing CPU is interfaced with two separate memories with Harvard architecture. One memory is there for program, but second memory will be there for data. So first of all, you should know what is the meaning of program and what is the meaning of data. Let me give you some basic examples. Like as if you want to play one MP3 file. So that MP3 file, audio song, that is a data. That file that is getting executed inside MP3 player, that is a program. So MP3 player, that is a program, and the file which you want to play, that is a data. Like as if you have one video file. So that video file is a data that you will be playing inside video player, like VLC media player, that will be program, right? So program that will be having sets of instructions, right? Program will be fixed. You cannot change the program. You can change the data, but you cannot change the program, right? Like for example, as if you have one PowerPoint presentation file. So that is a data that you will be opening with Microsoft PowerPoint presentation program. So program is fixed, right? Microsoft PowerPoint presentation program, that one cannot change once you install it inside your computer. But by having editing of that particular file of PPT, you can change the data of that PPT. So you'll be observing this CPU that will be reading program from the memory, right? But with data, it will perform two things. It may read the data from the memory as well as it may write the data onto the memory. So you'll be observing that this program memory, that will be ROM memory, and that data memory, that will be RAM memory, right? Let me explain you all those things with bit more clarity along with block diagram. So that will give you more clarity. So here, when we talk about Harvard architecture, you see this is CPU that will be accessing program memory as well as data memory. Program is there with ROM. Why? The reason is we cannot change the program. Here we will be just reading it from the memory. And with RAM, we have data. So here you will be performing two things, read and write. So with Harvard architecture, CPU is accessing two separate memories, ROM and RAM. ROM is the related program and RAM is the related data. So here with Harvard architecture, you will be having one basic advantage. What advantage? Along with program, you can access data. Why? The reason is, you see, here we have separate system bus, right? In von Neumann architecture, we were been having common memory for data and program. So at a time, either you access program or data, right? You cannot have both of the things simultaneously. But with Harvard architecture, program access and data access, that is possible at the same time as system bus are separate with Harvard architecture. And CPU structure is common for almost all the computer system, like it will be having control unit, resistors, ALU. And to give input, here you'll be having input devices, like you can have keyboard or mouse. And with output devices, you can have monitor, you can have printer, you can have speakers, right? So based on requirement, various output devices can be interfaced with CPU. Here, let me give you one more practical example so that will give you more clarity. Like you can observe here, one C language program is written. In that you see int a is equals to 8, b is equals to 5, and c that is written. What it means? Here we have defined integers a, b, and c. With a and b values are given, and c is integer that we have defined. So this is data that you can say, right? And this data that we can use it to perform any arithmetic task. Like you see here, we have written c is equals to b plus a. So when you compile this program from higher level language, what compiler does is it will be giving you machine language. And in machine language, you will be having program as well as data. And with Harvard architecture, you will be observing program and data that will be there in a separate memories. Here you cannot understand how data and program is there as it is written in terms of zeros and ones in machine language, right? But once you compile it, you will be having program and data. Data will be stored inside RAM, and program means it will be having instructions that will be stored inside ROM with Harvard architecture. So as I have said, with main memory, you can have RAM as well as ROM. In RAM, you will be holding data with Harvard architecture, and with ROM, will be holding program with Harvard architecture. Here, when we talk about control unit, then you should know this control unit, which is there inside CPU, that is controlling entire computer system. Like it generates all the control signals for memory read and memory write over here. With ROM, it generates memory read control signals. With RAM, it generates memory read as well as memory write control signals. With I/O devices, it will be generating I/O read and I/O write control signals. So all the control signals with these peripherals are generated by this control unit inside CPU. It is not only controlling peripherals, but it also controls internal operation of CPU. Like once you take instruction inside CPU, it will be performing instruction fetch operation, instruction decode operation. In some high-end computers, you'll be observing complex pipelining is there. That is also been controlled by this control unit. So in short, you can say all the control signals are controlled by control unit, which is there inside CPU. Here, when we talk about resistors, then you see here one block is given. But you should know there are many resistors which is there inside CPU, and with the use of resistors, this CPU is performing all the arithmetic and logical tasks and all the instruction execution, right? So in future coming videos, I'll be going to explain you how resistor organization is there with general purpose computer so that you can have idea about how many resistors are there. Here I have listed few resistors like general purpose resistors, flag resistor, stack resistor, program counter. So these resistors are used to execute any instructions inside CPU. Here, ALU is given. This ALU is responsible for performing all the arithmetic and logical tasks. Like you can perform addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, as well as all the logical tasks like AND operation, OR operation, XOR operation, NOT operation. So all the operations are performed by this ALU inside CPU. Here when we talk about I/O devices, then you should know we give command with the use of input devices. Like by using mouse and keyboard, we give command to CPU. And to observe output, we have output devices. Like you have monitor over here, you can have printer, you can have speaker to listen to your audio. So likewise, there are various output devices to see how our output is coming by execution of program. So in short, with Harvard architecture, you should understand one thing. When you interface memory, then for program and for data, you will be having separate memory, right? And because of Harvard architecture is having separate memory, access of program is fast. Why? The reason is separate data bus is there. So in parallel with instruction execution, data can be accessed over here. So execution speed with CPU in Harvard architecture is faster compared to von Neumann architecture. I hope it is clear to you. Still, if any confusion is there, just post that in comment box. I'll be happy to help you. Thank you so much for watching this video.